Okay, so at this point, I would like to introduce our speaker for this session, my colleague at Coach Francis Academy, Dr. Magda Tipoy, professional certified coach and PhD in international business and economics. Out of her home based in Romania, Magda has focused her career on international relations, and now she is an associate professor at Alexandru Ioan Cuza University and founder of Agape International Coaching Conference. Today, our speaker will discuss and highlight the concept of transformative coaching presence. The theory is that as you think, you vibrate, and energy vibrates at a particular frequency. The law of vibration activates the law of attraction, and through the law of deservedness, you attract what you send out by the emotions you hold in your body. In this webinar, you will rediscover the magic of transformative coaching presence when two, you and your client, become one, and how your vibration frequency can be raised to inspire more positive change in your client. I now leave it to Coach Magda to further introduce herself and to take you and to take us through this insightful presentation. Thank you so much, everyone. Magda, to you.
Now it's sure it's me.
Yes.
Okay, so thank you very much with gratitude for coming and for your interest. I see a lot of familiar faces. Hi to everyone. And I appreciate a lot that you take from your personal time or maybe family time and you choose to spend the next 50 minutes with us. So welcome. I see here 99 beautiful presence, and I want to acknowledge you and each and everyone that your presence is very, very important and you contribute to the energy of this webinar. So thank you again. My intention for today is to have a lot of fun with you and also to learn and to feel the bliss in your presence. And I hope you will feel it in mine also. But before we start, in order to be completely present here and not be distracted by, I don't know, something else, emails, messages, invoices to be paid, I'm speaking about me, and no multitasking, please. I propose you to take a few moments to connect with yourself and to forget for the next 50 minutes about all the noise in your daily work, yeah, about duties, about tasks, and to be fully present. Okay? Let's do it. So thank you. Thank you very much. Okay, ready to go? Wonderful. So I will tell you a story about a person who experienced several life-altering events throughout his life. And Dr. David Hawkins, a very well-known psychiatrist, believes that every single word we use, every thought, and every intention, you heard well, intention, creates what is called a morphogenetic field or an attractor field. And following each personal experience, he noticed a change in his state of consciousness from an ego-based, a mind focus, to a completely overwhelming state of overpowering bliss. And he decided that he must pursue the reason beyond all these changes. So he created a way to measure all these energy fields. And can you imagine? I was wondering how to measure something that it is invisible. This process tests the sound, the light, and the electromagnetic waves coming of this morphogenetic field of the human heart when someone is thinking, emoting, or creating. And in the first slide I prepare for you, I will present Dr. Hawkins' vibrational scale, which consists in hierarchy of level of human consciousness from 1 to 1,000, where 1 is simply being alive and 1,000 is an advanced state of enlightenment. And now I will ask kindly Lina to put the first slide in order to see the emotions that we have here and their level of calibration. So we have shame from down up. We have guilt, apathy, grief, fear, desire, anger, pride, and courage. Here at the level of courage is the very important frequency we will see soon. And we have neutrality, willingness, acceptance, reasons, love, joy, peace, and enlightenment. And how he calibrates this scale of expanding level of consciousness? Using the methods of muscle testing and kinesiology. It is very important to mention that the calibration figures do not represent an arithmetic, but a logarithmic progression. So thus the level 300, for instance, it is not twice the amplitude of 150. It is 300 to the 10th power. For instance, a normal, healthy human body should resonate with a natural frequency around 60, 65. Thank you, Lina. There are far fewer people at the higher levels than at the lower one. And an increase from one level to another will result in enormous changes in your life. And this scale I show you is by no way meant to define anyone at a fixed place. And no level is wrong or right. As a human being, we fluctuate through the different calibration levels. This scale is simply a highly accurate and very useful way to understand where we are in terms of conscious awareness. We all have been at low levels in certain moments of our lives, as it is necessary for achieving the higher planes of awareness. Because these lower levels contain core lessons that we all must learn at some point in order to attain the full realm of the human experience with all its lows and highs and challenges. Okay, 90% of the people on Earth, I'm curious, at what level do you think they are? At what level do you think they vibrate? I will tell you. They live below the level of courage, which is 200. So given so much negativity, you might be asking, why hasn't humanity already destroyed our civilization? This is due to the fact that the positivity of the people operating on higher consciousness level counterbalances the negativity of thousands or even millions of other people. And to give you an example, a person who calibrates 300 level will counterbalance 90,000 of individuals who calibrate below 200. Or a person that it is at the level of love, 500, it will counterbalance 550,000 individuals who calibrate below 200. So maybe this explains why Mahatma Gandhi, whom Hawkins calibrated at 760, was able to convince more than 100 million people to follow his philosophy of non-violence. So how we can raise our own level of consciousness? Everything that is around us can affect our level of consciousness. So the music we are listening to, the people whom we associate, the food we eat, the books we read, even the shows that we watch, and the perfume we use. There are so many ways to increase our vibration frequency. For instance, in aromatherapy, I'm curious if some one of you use essential oils? Who use essential oils? There are essential oils with such a high vibration. For instance, rose calibrates 320, lavender around 120, and melissa around 100. So what about music? For instance, specific types of music contains violent lyrics will resonate at a low frequency. Beatles music, for instance, calibrates 560 hertz. And now I will invite you to listen to music. I prepared a slide. Selina, please, next slide. Invite you to this listen calibrate over 500. And I'm curious, after we will listen it, to see how it will land for you and how you will feel after. Eugen Doga is one of my favorite composers. So it's a Romanian and lives in Moldova, very beautiful country from where Margareta is. So hi, Margareta, thank you for coming. And his famous waltz from the film My Sweet and Tender Beast was named by United Nations Educational, Scientific and Cultural Organization one of the first musical masterpieces of the 20th century. So I will put this music to listen. And it will be very good if you can stand up and with your arms up to the sky. In all this period of 3 minutes, if it will be perfect, if you can keep your hand there. If not, and they will hurt you, you can bring them here to the chest. Okay? Let's hear the music.
Thank you.
Thank you. I hope the sound was good. I hope you heard. Okay, please share with me. Oh, I see a... Oh. Who wants to share? How do you feel? Oh, thank you, Rainbow. Thank you for your contribution. Yes, raising our hands helps the energy flow better. Who wants to share the experience? Okay, Rakesh, no problem. You forget about hands. Tell us, how did you feel?
The music, it had a lot of, it took you on a ride, so to speak, you know? So for me, I just try to go with it in a way to see what it is. I mean, probably curiosity, you know? So, and I was like, wow, it's like so famous. It's like the fourth, right? As per what you said, it's one of the best. What could it be? So I was just curious about it. And so it just went on and I was like, oh, actually my hands are up. I just close my eyes so that I don't have to get distracted with, the screen and so on. So yeah, in a way, it just intrigued me to be more curious about it. Yeah, that was my experience.
Thank you. Thank you so much. So a little contribution in the chat, refreshing, energy flowing, enlightening, happiness, gratitude, spring. Okay, I'm glowing with the music. Thank you, Jacqueline. I feel light, very uplifting. Thank you, Jennifer. Calming. Okay, getting higher. Okay, I saw Martina. I saw a hand raised, please.
Yeah, music just uplifts us. Not only it just speaks to all of our senses. We can sense it. It flows into our body and just affects and speaks to every part of our brain and affects so every part of our body. And for that, we feel that energy flowing through our whole body, and it's very impactful and empowers us to feel more, to have another sensing also outwards, not only inwards, also outwards. Very powerful.
Thank you so much, Martina. And another contribution in the chat, energy flow, body wanted move, powerful movement, presence. Oh, it was amazing. I felt like vibrating different emotions from sadness to happiness, refreshing, gratitude, happiness. Okay. Thank you. Thank you very much to all for your contribution. And coming to this presence, I'm curious, what this presence is? I mean, not just in coaching, the presence in general. What is presence? Can you go to the chat? Energy. Yes. The neuropsychologist Dan Siegel described this presence, not necessarily coaching presence, as I said, but presence itself as a fully in the now, undistracted by the past or the future or by one's own personal needs, is calm, positive, maintains open awareness, hasn't decided how things should be, is supportive of others, curious about the next moment, but it is very important in the flow. Here in the next slide, I want to show you where is this flow calibrated. So Lina, if you can put the next slide, I can show you why you cannot be in this presence if you didn't find your inner peace. You see, the flow starts to be up the level of 200. The level of courage. This is that area where we expanded, we nourished. Under the level of courage, there are suffering and contracted. Did you notice? Thank you so much, Lina. Did you notice that masterful coaches in their coaching sessions how they behave. I mean, they are still. Presence is a state of consciousness that a few people experience in their day to day. Why? Because presence is a challenge. Because our egos think they know what to do, what to say, what to advise, but our thoughts and emotions carry this frequency, this vibration, and the wave. And emotions that we have can very much affect us. In order to how the energy moves and flows, and how we carry our emotion in our mind, in body and heart, can cause to experience these contractions or fears or expansion. These emotions are stored at the cellular level of our body, and they can be released or even cleared during energy healing treatment or through energy dance, restoring our energy flow. For instance, if we are in fear, in anger, or just worry, we experience this contraction and even destruction at cellular level. When experiences this, our growth is challenged and our body is impacted and our energy flow restricted. Anger, you know, many people nowadays complains a lot and get angry for nothing. This anger can often be one of the most damaging into our body because it shuts down the power of the heart. And our heart energy is a powerhouse source of our energy. We are most powerful when our hearts are open. And I know coaches are people with their hearts open. If you ask a master coach, for instance, what they bring to coaching that it is the most important, they will probably say, coaching presence. What is it and why it is so important? In co-creation, the relationship, I'm sure you know that ICF competencies 5, this maintains presence. Say that is fully conscious and present with the client, employing a style that it is open, flexible, grounded, and confident. And the state of consciousness that it is presence is contagious. When we come with this state at a coaching session, others often slip into it too. And this is the state that invites insights, expanded awareness, creativity, and confidence. All qualities that help a client grow, find resourceful solutions, and act upon them. And this is the goal of transformative coaching. And this remarkable state of mind virtually eliminates the need to help, to advise, to solve, or to teach our clients anything. So presence is the essential quality of a transformative professional coach. It can be observed how transformative master coaches willingly enter into this intimate form of interpersonal resonance with their clients and create the necessary condition that allow original emerging solutions to naturally and magically surface. This exceptional quality of presence first creates alignment with the client in order to allow partnering to tune in together in an harmoniously vibrate as one. There are no more two persons. The two become one. being in the same breath. I'm curious to ask you, did you notice in or experienced the mirror neurons in your coaching sessions? Or did you feel the emotions that your client felt? So in effect, transformative coaching presence thus become shared resonance. And this resonance creates a collective context that serves as a receptacle for new forms, solutions, and perspectives to literally surface and almost propel the coaching partners into new realms of conscience. Simple. The most often is humble. The whole and attentive coaching presence is totally sufficient to embark willing transformative coaches and clients into this totally unexpected new dimension. Because this true deep presence allows the relationship between the coach and the client to literally become an aspiring, inspiring, and even inspirating vacuum waiting to be filled with novel forms. Sometimes it is surprising how a simple, empty, free, and transparent receptacle facilitate the emergence of a truly new, unexpected, and liberating perspectives. So there are so many ways to increase our presence. And for today, I choose to share with you one way that will allow you from the moment of this webinar will come to an end to apply it. Happy with this? Curious to find out more? Okay, so I choose something that it can be see and hear. It is about voice, about human voice. It is such a powerful instrument at which we all play every day. So it is a blowing instrument. And it is probably the most powerful sound in the world that can start a war or can say, I love you. So how can we speak in order to make our presence felt, to increase the presence? Julian Treasure, it is a sound consultant. I don't know if you heard about him, but now is the moment, if not. So all his life, he listened to voices, thousands and thousands of voices, and he associates a human voice with a toolbox. But unfortunately, very few people use it. Even there are people that never open this toolbox in their lives. I have a slide prepared for you in order to see what I prepare for you. And the first single one, number one, it is register. And falsetto register cannot be very useful most of the time. But there is a register in between. And you can locate your voice, however. So if I'm talk up here in my nose, you can hear a difference. If I'm speaking from my throat, which is where most of us speak most of our time. And if you want weight, you need to go here, down to the chest. Can you feel the difference? We vote for politicians with lower voices. It is true, because we associate depth with the power and with authority. And research shows that people prefer low voices. Second is the timbre. Lina, you can put away the slide because I want to see you better. The timbre, it is the way your voice feels. And researchers shows again that people prefer rich, smooth, and warm voices, like hot chocolate. And if it is not your case yet, this is another good news, because you can train it. You can go and take a voice coach. Have you an idea that it's such an important profession, this one? Many Hollywood stars have voice coaches. There is a lady, Patty Rodenburg, is one of them. And she's working with all these famous actors. She wrote the Second Circle book. I highly recommend it to you. So in order to improve our timbre, we can breath deep, not superficial from chest, but deep from the abdomen, from the belly, the tummy. We should take care to our posture. And there are many other exercises. I'm very aware about the time and I will move forward quick. So we have prosody, but I love prosody. This is my favorite. This is the sing song. This is the meta language that we use in our coaching session in order to impart meaning. It is root one in meaning in a conversation. Is that para verbal message? People who are speak all on one note are really quite hard to follow, to listen to. That is where the word monotonic comes from monotonous, monotone. And we also have repetitive prosody, now coming in where every sentence ends as it is a question, where it is actually not a question, it is a statement. So if you repeat this over and over, it will restrict your ability to communicate through prosody. And this will be such a pity. The next one is pace. And I know a lot of coaches know what it is. I can get very, very excited by saying something very, very quick, or I can slow down. Now, to in phase. And at the end of pace, it is silence. We don't have to fill it with It is highly recommended to have silence in your transformative coaching session. It can be very powerful. I know you know, but knowing is not doing. Pitch. Pitch often goes along with a pace to indicate arousal, but you can do it just with pitch. Where did you leave my keys? Where did you leave my keys? So, slightly different meaning in those two deliveries. The last one, it is volume. I can get really excited by using volume, or I can have you really pay attention by getting very quiet. So this is the toolbox. You already have it, and it's for free. Just use it. One more step is that the engine that is going to work on should be warmed up. So first, warm up your voice. Do you want me to show you how to do it? Thank you, Berenice. Okay, let's stand up for a moment. Again, we will make exercises in the also. Okay, so we stand up and I will show you some vocal warm-up exercises to do before every coaching session you have or every important talk. So arms up again, and we will make like inhale from here, from the abdomen, and then exhale, okay? So Ah, very good. One more time. So again, inhale from the abdomen and then, ah, wonderful. Next, we will warm up our lips and we will say like, but not behind in our throat, but here in front, like we feel the lips. And then we can go with ba, ba. Come on, let's unmute yourself, please. I want to hear you all. Okay, so please unmute. Let's see. Ba. Now, when you were just a kid, we are making it like brr. Okay, let's have this one. Okay, thank you. Susan, you'll love this. Now, in this moment, your lips should be coming alive. Okay? We go next. We go next to the tongue. And we will exaggerate a little bit with la. La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La. La.
La.
La.
La.
La.
La. La.
La.
La.
La. La.
La.
La.
La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. La. It is R, but saying like R.
Oh, I can't do that.
I'm trying.
So the last one, the pros call this siren. The siren starts with we and continues with o, but the we is high and the o is low. Okay? So let's try again. Everybody that contributed. Wonderful, wonderful. Thank you very much. You can go on mute now. Thank you. And now you have practiced it, you have the toolkit, you are ready for your next coaching session, or I don't know what important conversation you will have. And now I invite you to listen what Maria, she's a student and also my client, can do with her voice. During a show called Romanian Got Talents, she performed in this show last month. And let's share my screen to see if you can also see her. Okay.
Is the end.
Was for you, what did you notice? What did you notice in her voice? Who wants to share? Oh, I see in the chat, so powerful. Give me some chills. Oh, again, singing. Oh, yeah, high, very high pitch. Yes, what did you notice on the voice? Maybe you can speak, you can share with us
everything from the toolkit.
Yes.
wonderful, this was my objective. Rakesh, yes. Thank you so much. Yeah, you see the easiness in the singing, because she was singing with a column of air in the spine. There are some techniques, but Maria is more than a client. It is like a daughter for me. It is our best friend daughter. And I invited her to sing live for us today here. But tomorrow she will have the semi-final competition of this show. And today was recording all day long. She promised me next time we'll be together with us and I will sing for you also. I made some canto. Okay, so we are getting too close. Years ago, when I worked in Brussels, I met Dalai Lama in the European Parliament, and I remember so clear his words. He said, "The planet does not need more successful people. The planet desperately needs more peacemakers, healers, restorers, storytellers, and lovers of all kind. The first thing we need to do, is to trace back of our lives and see how we have been moving through the scale to figure out where we currently are. Awareness is always the first step. Let's strengthen our self-awareness as a coach, practicing meditation, prayers, I don't know, reading book, eating high vibration food. This is a big piece here with the food. Using aromatherapy or working with spiritual leaders. can also be great. It help you increase your presence and raise your personal vibration frequency. When we are vibrating high, we are healthy, happy, full of energy, full of positive energy and inspirational. People just love to be in our presence. And in this way, we will be able to help others to be a source of positive change for this world. I will finish here with my last slide and with the words of Mother Teresa. This is a message, the burning message I want to give it to you. So go out into the world today and love the people you meet. Let your presence light new light in the heart of others. So thank you so much, and back to you, Lina.
Lina. Thank you so much, Magda. Thank you so much. What a fabulous presentation. Magda, thank you so much. Now we can know where your beauty is coming from. Huh? The secret of your beauty, this inner peace. Thank you so much. So we're going to open the floor now. If you have any question or would you like to share anything on your mind, please go ahead. Just introduce yourself and step in.
Yeah, before questioning, I would love to hear if anything was useful for you who wants to share. What you take away?
Can I share something? Can you hear me?
Yes, Bernice, loud and clear.
Thank you. Magdalena, thank you very much for your presentation. Very beautiful. In the whole, the best that I take away from here is that you presented and what you tried to communicate to us, you lifted, you embodied yourself. And now I see why every time I see you, since I met you, you know, in SEME, every time you speak, it's so energizing. It's so, what you told us today, you live it every day. So this communicates through, indeed, through the coaching sessions, every time you speak. So even, and what I say sometimes, even what we do not communicate verbally communicates. And you have showed us how to put all these pieces together. Everything comes from within, from what we think, what we hear, what we see. Everything is the whole of us, and this is how we come across to the clients and to the people. So it's very beautiful, very powerful, the entire session today. Thank you so much for putting it so beautifully, so artfully as well, and also together with the voice. It's a topic I am very interested in. Some time ago, I started noticing also something I would like to work on. And you have given us today very good tips and tricks. Thank you so much, Magda, for today.
Thank you very much. Thank you. I see
you. Hi, yeah. Thank you so much, first of all, for a wonderful session. It's beautiful, and the energy is amazing. It's a great reminder for the use of our presence in coaching sessions, but beyond that, on a personal level, sometimes being a positive person can be difficult because there's so much negativity around, but it's really nice and heartwarming to hear that higher vibration does have an impact and does counteract against other negative energies. So that's really nice to know that, to keep pushing with the positivity because it can be hard sometimes. So I really appreciate that. And it gives me more energy to continue being positive. So thank you.
Thank you very much, Hassan. Yes. So, Lina, back
anyone
to you.
Else would like to share anything before we move on? Because we're mindful about the time and we don't want to keep you late. Anyone else would like to share anything? Okay. So, for the new guest, I would like you to know that there are many webinars that we are running during this week still, every day until Friday. Okay. Oh, there's someone, Margarita, I'm sorry. You want to share something?
Yeah, thank you. Thank you. I'm still living the moments you created, Magda. Beautiful. Absolutely fantastic. Thank you so much for this absolutely fantastic session, presentation, and helping us to come into this spirit, into this presence. Thank you so much. That was absolutely impressive for me. And it's a topic of great interest for me, how to be present, how to learn to be present for the client, how to be there, not only with the body, but with the mind, with the spirit. And thank you. Thanks a lot for the tools you provided today and for raising this topic at this height. Thanks a lot. Beautifully done, masterfully delivered. Great atmosphere. Thank you.
Thank you, Margarita. Thank you. Yay. So again, for the new guest, I have two announcements for you, and I'm going to leave the third one for Magda at the end of the session. Okay, so the first one is that all participants who are guests today, they will be entitled a $100 voucher to attend our transformative core training for the period that will be running from June till September. And it's only eligible for guests who are joining us today. So if you are ready to inspire a change in your life, like Magda is doing, and join our core training, we are offering you a $100 if you register in our core training. All you need to do is to email us at info@coachmastersacademy.com. And I'm going to stop the recording now because I'm going to announce the